Hello everyone, welcome back in today's tutorial on Informatica MDM. In today's tutorial, we are going to see the remaining part of the recommendation for the Informatica MDM Hub. So let's start today's session. The parameter we are going to see, the first parameter is mostly related to the cleans function. So first cleans function, which is we have to implement very carefully, is nothing but read database. Normally this is used to read the database and achieve the cleansing of the input data. So we have to use with very caution, and we have to make sure we have enabled the cache if you're using the read database. The read database cleans function incurs a performance overhead compared to other similar cleans function. So if you're going to use the read database, definitely you have to take care a lot. If you use this function cannot be added, and if applicable, enable caching behavior of the read database function. Pass a boolean flag as a false for the clear cache input field of the read database. So if you use the read database, there is a one parameter called as a clear cache. We have to pass the false value for that. Doing so reduces the performance lag by enabling future operations to use the cached value rather than creating new database connection for the each request. So this thing need to be considered while using the read database cleans function. If you are using any other cleans function, make sure your cleans function is not complicated. It should be very straightforward and simple. The reason is it has a direct impact on the stage and the load job. So if you are using the more complicated cleans function, the batch job's performance will be impacted. The next thing is timeline. We also call it the versioning. The dynamic timeline or the versioning must be enabled on the entity base object. Regular base object, not an HM related base object, if strictly required. Versioning has a performance impact on the base object associated with it. For HM relationship base object, versioning is enabled with no option to disable. So once it is enabled, we cannot disable the timeline. So make sure while enabling the timeline, you have to consider all the scenarios. State management. Disable state management if you do not require it. The reason is actually it carries an associated performance overhead. If you use IDD with workflows, you must enable state management. However, enabling history for the state management promotion at cross-reference level is optional. Now the recommendation for the delta detection. Enable the delta detection only on the minimum number of columns. Sometimes, recently in one of the project, we told by business that they are not sure which column is going to change, whether they are going to give us last updated column as a change or not. So they ask us to enable the delta detection on the all the columns. We told them that if it is data set is lower volume, we can enable, but if you are going to get a high volume of data and if we enable the delta detection on the all the column, then it will be a performance hit on the jobs. So by considering that fact, the business think that they need to think on the what are the columns which will give us a delta. In most of the scenario, last updated column is more appropriate to use for the delta detection. Do not go and blindly select all the columns for the delta detection. Cleans mapping. Minimize the complexity of the mapping. Do not overuse the cleans function or do not use the complicated mapping. So always use the simplest way to use the cleans function and the mapping. Suppose LTrim and the RTrim. If you're using the ETL tool or if you're using IDKey tool, that is Informatica data quality tool, make sure you clean the data in those tool itself instead of making overhead in the MDM side. Because MDM deals with the more and more jobs, such as it has a stage job, load job, match job, merge job, tokenization, etc. So each job will be have the impact. So each one has the dependence on each other. So if there is a way to cleanse the data well before the landing into the MDM, it is good to do that. So IDQ, I think the best way to do that. Validation rule, optimize validation rules, SQL code. The detection piece of the each validation rule SQL runs against the every record during the load process to determine if it applies. So definitely it will be applicable to all the record. That means your validation rule will be applicable or will be causing the performance hit. Next thing is packages. Optimize the SQL code written in the MDM queries, which is called for the MDM hub packages. So the MDM hub packages used in the IDD, SIP API, or the data manager, merge manager, or in any search operation, etc. If we do not tune the MDM hub for the performance, it results in expensive operation. So whenever you configure the packages, make sure what kind of joins you are using. Are you using inner join, outer join? So use the appropriate join condition, use the appropriate filter condition to give the or to tune the packages SQL queries. User exit. Optimize user exit code for the performance. Of course, our user exit we write in the Java, and we know the Java is a very robust language. It may lead to the memory leakage or usage of the object or non-proper implementation in the Java code. So make sure your implementation is appropriate. The code review must have done a the code quality has to be done, and try to optimize the user exit for the better performance instead of non-use. Whenever it is not required, do not use the objects, do not create unnecessary object, which will cause the overall performance issue. Custom indexes. This is very important. Custom indexes are definitely used to achieve the better performance of your jobs and the functionality. So whenever you create a custom index, there should be a proper care need to be taken. Use a caution when adding the custom indexes. Each index added has an associated cost. Ensure that gain received outweigh the cost of each additional custom index. The reason why we are introducing index or custom indexes is to achieve the better performance. If you are not properly using those indexes, it may have a bad impact on the overall performance. So there are some certain number of recommendation is given by the Informatica to improve the performance cost. The first is get a log of real query run on the base object and the base object shadow table on any given day. Ignore the temporary tables which start with T dollar percentage table and also the C repos table. Just ignore those and take only the base object data. Identify the indexes which exist on this table to avoid unnecessary overlap. Before adding any indexes, review a regular day log and take an inventory of. While taking the inventory, we have to consider three basic things: SIP API call duration, IDD processing duration, and batch job. In the batch job, of course, we have to take how long each job is taking, how long each cycle with that batch job is taking, and duration of the longest running statements. So you have to consider this factor. What are the factor which is causing or which will have the impact on the indexes? Consider the longest running process for the potential benefit for the custom index. So it could be a SIP API process, it could be an IDD process, or it could be a batch job. So consider any of that. Consider adding the indexes so longest running SQL query or the queries hit the new index in their execution plan. Avoid indexing field which have the many updates or inserts. So after each new custom index added, return to again step three, that is determining on each side like SIP API, IDD or the batch, and assess if there is a still potential or there is still chance to improve the performance. So it is a more repetitive process to improve the performance by adding the indexes. Next parameter is parallel degree on the base object. It's a very interesting property. Between one and number of CPU cores on database machine. So parallel degree is like processing a job on multiple threads, or we can run the jobs on the parallel. So parallel degree is advanced base object property. For optimum performance of the batch job, set value between one and number of processes cores on the database server machine. So if you have suppose three CPU cores on the database machines, so we can configure this value between one and three like that. Next property is related to the MDM hub recommended by the Informatica is nothing but match path filter. Filter on the root path instead at the match root level. So what recommendation? So we have the various locations where we can configure the filter. Filter, if you configure the root level, root path, it will be more performance, a better performance approach rather than configuring on the match root level. If you need to execute records from the match process, filter on the root path instead of at the match root level, because whenever you filter the root path, the number of records going to process will be ultimately filtered. So no need to, it will not have the impact on the match rules. You have the better performance when the executing the match rules, because the set of the data will be less. When you filter at the root level, it executes the records from the tokenization and they therefore do not participate in the match. That's definitely true. Next is check for missing children. Use it with caution. So this is one of the property we configure during the base object configuration. The match path property indicate if parent records must be considered for the matching based on the existence of the child record. So if the child record is there and if you consider for the parent matching, we have this property. If you need a fuzzy match on the base object, tokenization of parent base object record must occur. So tokenization of parent base object record occurs if all children base or all child base object that have the option to check for the missing children disabled. So definitely this is very critical property with respect to match job performance. So use this property with care. Next thing is related to the match key. Tighter the key, the better the performance, that we know. So if you use the tighter key for the matching, your performance will definitely be better. So that is the reason it is recommended you add some exact column in your match rule, which will give you the more tighter match key. The width of the match key determines the number of rows in the tokenization table, number of tokenization record which are used to match each record to be matched. The number of records to be considered for the each match candidate is based on the tokenization table. Usually the standard key width is enough. So don't do with like a very exhaustive key generation. So standard key width is enough. Search level. Use the narrowest possible search level to generate the acceptable matches. Usually the typical search level is enough. Yes, of course you can try with whenever you start developing the solution, try with a different type of search level. Normally typical search level is enough, but if it is not satisfying your business requirement, you can change this search level. Match rules. Each match rule add one or more exact match columns to act as a filter and improve the performance of each rule that we discussed. Dynamic match analysis threshold. This is also one of the property we need to consider. Change if required. Default value is zero. Then we have the next property, strip CTS delete ratio. So change if it is required. Default value is 10. Default value is 10%. We have to definitely do the proper analysis while optimizing this property, or if you want to change this property. So if the volume of data or data change in the strip table is more than this percentage, tokenization would result use create table on the select segment. So code to recreate shift table will be needed to change rather than delete and insert operation to achieve the same result in the less time. So there are some like backend process we can do to achieve the better performance, but instead of doing the extra work, make sure you use the optimum value for this property. Then we have the complete steep ratio. Proper alignment is definitely required, as like the steep CTS delete ratio property before optimizing this value. Default value is 60%. If the your number of data change go beyond this percentage, then the tokenization will happen on the all the data set. We have the next property, auto merge CTS ratio. Change if it is required, default value is -1. As like other property, we also have need to do the proper analysis before changing this value. If the volume of record queued for the merge is greater than this percentage, auto merge uses the create table as select option for the faster merging instead of regular delete and insert option. Default value is -1, which indicates this is create table as select feature is off for the auto merge. If you want to enable, you have to change the value. So these are the properties, or these are the recommendation from the Informatica you have to consider while implementing the Informatica MDM hub solution. I hope these tutorials are going to help you to understand the MDM in better way. Thank you for watching my video, and do not forget to subscribe my channel. Have a nice time.